Yes, students, now one more numerical based on the law of chemical combination. Okay, so your question here is, when 3 gram of carbon is burnt in 8 gram of oxygen, when 3 gram of carbon is burnt in 8 gram of oxygen, 11 gram of carbon dioxide is produced. Look here, students. When 3 gram of carbon is burnt in 8 gram of oxygen, 11 gram of carbon dioxide is produced. This is given in the question. Okay. So here first we will see, what is this carbon and oxygen? These are the reactants. And what is carbon dioxide? Product. So, mass of reactants is equal to mass of, what are the reactants? Carbon and oxygen. Mass of carbon plus mass of oxygen. So what is mass of carbon? 3. And what is mass of oxygen? 8. 3 plus 8 is equal to 11 gram. So what is this? This is mass of reactants. Now what is the product? Total mass of reactant. Next. Total mass of products. What is the product? Carbon dioxide. So mass of carbon dioxide, how much? 11 gram. So this is mass of product. Okay. So what you observe here in this reaction, when carbon is burnt, it combines with 3 gram carbon, combines with 8 gram oxygen. It is burnt in 8 gram oxygen. Then how much carbon dioxide is produced? 11 gram. In this, total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. So, which law it proves here? Law of conservation of mass. What is law of conservation of mass? In any chemical reaction, total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. So, here, total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of products. So it proves law of conservation of mass. Okay, now one more is there. Now what is your question? What mass of carbon dioxide will be formed when 3 gram of carbon is burnt in 50 gram of oxygen? Here what is given? 3 gram carbon is burnt in 8 gram oxygen. So how much carbon dioxide is produced? 11 gram. Now what is said? If 3 gram carbon, what mass of carbon dioxide will be produced? It is asked. What mass of carbon dioxide will be produced when 3 gram of carbon is burnt in 50 gram of oxygen? How much oxygen taken? 50 gram. So how much carbon dioxide will be produced? It is asked. So what you have seen here, you know already that in carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen combine in which ratio? 3:8 by mass. This we know. In carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen combine together in fixed ratio by mass. What is that? 3:8 by mass. So, this 3 gram of carbon will combine with fixed mass of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide. So, here 3 gram of carbon, it is burnt in 50 gram of oxygen, but It will react with how much oxygen? It will react with only 8 gram oxygen. So carbon dioxide produced will be again the same. How much? 11 gram. Because 3 gram carbon to burn, how much oxygen is required? 8 gram only. So out of 50, how much carbon oxygen it will use? 8 gram. So the carbon dioxide produced again will be the same. What will be that? 11 gram. And the rest oxygen will remain uncombined. That is 50 minus 8, 42 gram of oxygen will remain uncombined. Okay. Yes, students. Yes. Further, it also shows that carbon dioxide contains carbon and oxygen in fixed proportion by mass. That is 3:8 by mass. So it proves law of constant proportion. So because in the question it is asked, which law of chemical combination will govern your answer? First, you'll explain it proves law of conservation of mass, because total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. Second, to solve this part, 3 gram carbon dioxide, 3 gram carbon when burnt in 50 gram oxygen, how much carbon dioxide is produced? So, we know that in carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen combine in which ratio? 3:8 by mass. So 3 gram carbon will combine with only 8 gram oxygen only. So carbon dioxide produced again will be the same, that is 11 gram. So here, which law it governs? It proves law of constant proportion. Okay, so next, as 3 gram carbon combines with fixed mass of oxygen, so carbon dioxide gas produced will again be the same, that is 11 gram. And oxygen left uncombined will be how much? 50 minus 8 is equal to 42 gram. This much oxygen remains uncombined. It is left uncombined.